All right, a couple little things I wanted to show you here. We're finishing off the baggage doors, and as you can see, I've replaced the paneling inside. When I rebuilt these, I put new skin on the outside and new paneling on the inside, put it all back together. I used a circular wire brush on the metal, gives it that, it cleans off all the pitting, gets that satin finish, so forth, all that good stuff. And now I should have drilled these holes all the way through when I was building the doors, and instead I came in and I screwed the hinges in, then I decided to deal with it. That's mainly because I needed to get the thing closed up to keep the cats out for a while until I figured out what I was going to do. What I'm using are these type of latches, which are very almost exactly the same as what came with it, but we didn't have any keys for the ones that came with it, and they were all, you know, messed up and dirty and everything, so decided to get some new ones. So I found these at Ace Hardware. They're nickel plated. They also have gold, but I didn't want gold because everything else is shiny, you know, chrome look. So this is what I wanted. Now the only problem is that they only have this much sticking up to catch anything, so you can't just dig a hole up in the top here and hope that that's going to catch. But I'll show you how to deal with that later. In the meantime, we got a mortise out for this thing to set down in there so that it's flush. So that's what I'm going to do now. I'm going to show you how I did it. Did it on the other side already. It worked great. A lot of my stuff is experiments, especially on these Shastas. Just about everything on a Shasta is an experiment. So all I did was drop it down in the hole and go ahead and, you know, take your pencil and scribe a line all the way around it. And now we're going to go ahead and mortise it out, and we're going to use our trusty multi-tool. Okay, so here we go. Now let me just go ahead and double check the camera, make sure it's pointed the right direction and all that. And yeah, okay. So yeah, there is everything in the center. All I did was I took this. Well, now I have to change it, actually. Do I? No, okay, it's okay. I've tilted this a little bit. It's not exactly, you know, just so I could get to the corner here. So, it's almost just exactly perpendicular to the tool. Anyway, I'm going to be using just the corner here to go ahead and deal with this. It'll cut through the metal and everything. Okay, there we go. That pops right out. And I got a little bit of stuff left in there from glue or whatever when I was putting it all back together. I want to get out of the way because you want to just get down to the bare framing. I just clean that out with my razor knife here. Go. It's about. All right. Okay, this drops in this way. There, and you see it fits down nice and flush there. All right. Now we're just going to screw it in. Too tight at first. Let's get it flush. Let's get this cord in the way. Back in there. All right, there we are. All right, now the other problem we have to deal with is we have to have a latch in there. I'll show you what I found that works great with these. These are your typical latches for like the screen door. It's that little thumb, you know, spring-loaded roller latch. And it comes with, let me get this opened up. The knees are really hurting me right now. At my left knee, I hurt it the other morning, and it's really bothering me to be on it. Comes with two sizes of catches. I'm using the larger one. Okay? And I've already figured out where it needs to be. And basically, you just have to line it up with that. I'm going to show you here. There. All right, basically, with that open, what it's got to do is come in contact on that side of that there. So what we do is we have this thing mounted up there like that, and it gets latched on that side, okay? So it works out pretty good, actually. Everything just seems to fit perfect. So it was one of those accidental discoveries that worked out really good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and mount this up here. Let's see if I can get the camera pointed the right way. And boy, am I crowded in here. Okay. What I'm going to do, is just take my pencil, line things up. I'm going to make a little mark on my brow here, because you can't even see that. There, I can see it, but you can't. Then we'll make a mark here. And mark there. That shows us where our latch has to be. And from what I found is that all you have to do is mount this thing so that it's about just under an eighth of an inch in from the edge of this, and it works perfect. Now this thing is adjustable back and forth because you see the slots? So if you put the screw in the middle, put one screw in the middle, don't even put the other screw in yet, you can adjust it if you need to, and we're gonna go through that right now. So the one thing I gotta tell you is that first of all, you're gonna need to drill a pilot hole, because it's just you're not gonna be able to get that screw in otherwise. So hang on a second. Okay. Get everything out of my way because I'm really crowded here. And I'm old and I'm hurting. So, first thing we got to do here is get a drill bit going. I'm using a little bitty drill bit, smaller than the screw that I'm going to be using. Okay. put this where I think it needs to be, basically. And then, like I say, I'm going to... I'm going to drill a hole in the middle of the slot. As I get where I want it here, I'll drill a hole in the middle of the slot. That way we can adjust it back and forth. Thing wrong with these chucks, these keyless chucks, takes two or three times to get these little grabber guys to be on the flat sides of your bits. I don't like them. Yeah, they're still quicker than using a key, but I still don't like them. It just bugs me. I hate it when things don't work right. Okay, let's put a screw in that. Tighten it down where I think it needs to be. Before we even put the other screw in, we'll give it a quick test and see if this door will close and stay closed. Oh, it's a little tight, so I need to bring it back. It's a little tight, so I'll just, because the key won't turn all the way. So I'm going to loosen it and bring it back just a bit. Now it will go all the way. For some reason it's not. Not going all the way. Okay. Let's slide it back a little bit. Or I don't know why it won't go all the way. You know, it worked fine on the other side first time. Amazing. Yep, it did work fine the other first time. I'm thinking that maybe, I'll have to go look at the other side. Okay, the only thing I've been able to figure out is that it's bottoming out. In other words, this door is higher or the top is lower, and this thing won't extend all the way. Sure did work good on the other side. So that means that what I've got to do is I've either got to grind the top of this off a little bit or push this all up. And I think the best thing to do is to grind this off a little bit. So that's what I'm going to do. Said everything worked out fine on the other side when I didn't have the camera on. Here we go. Remember to use safety glasses. I happen to use sunglass safety glasses because that way they double for sunglasses and I work out in the sun a lot. But use safety glasses. This is the problem. I'm pretty sure it is. Let's see. I'm going to to go too far, you'll not latch. Close all the way. Okay, here's what we're going to do. We're going to run a test. I'm going to unscrew the thing all together and see if that's why it won't close all the way. Before I grind any more off. Really, the other side I didn't have to grind any off. Okay, that is not the problem then. The problem is, I don't know. Okay, I figured out the problem by looking at the other one. Okay, it's just a matter of depth. I got to grind a little bit more off here. But what it's doing is, it's not latching on the other side of this like I thought it was doing. It's latching right in here, going up in here. So that's okay, it works, as long as it works. It's going right up in here, making its latch. So all we got to do is grind it down a little bit further. I can always go get another one if I have to, if I go too far. I'm going to put this back up in there now. Like I say, sometimes these things are experiments. I'm just going to leave one screw in it for the time being. We're going to grind a little bit more off of this. It's amazing. I mean, the difference between the two, I mean, I guess this one's just much closer tolerance than the other one was. They built these Shastas with such big tolerances that they just, I don't know what holds them together for 50 years, to be honest with you. Time till we get it, see what that does. Almost, a little bit more, a little bit more, it's almost there. Boy, we are so close. I don't want to go too far because, yeah, we are so close. There, I got the key out. That's when you know you're there. You just don't want it so tight that you can't get the key out. I mean, that you break the key off in there. So it's a little tight. I'm going to go just a little bit further. Might even be able to move that thing around instead. Let's move this back just a hair. That should give it a little bit more room to go up. Let's try that. That's better. Okay, I like that. Now I'm happy. Okay, now we'll go ahead and put the other screw in. So we'll drill a hole first. Be patient with this stuff. I mean, most everything isn't going to work the first time, for one thing. Lots of things just go flat out wrong. Things that you don't intend to happen all the time. It really can be frustrating. Especially when you're on camera saying, I know what to do, and I'm going to show you how not to do it. Let's see if that works. There you go. Now I'm happy with that. Doesn't that look good? That's where we're going to leave it. Now, it just so happens that these roller catches come with two of these things. One's just a little different than the other, and I don't know what the difference is really, but that way I can still use these roller catches for my screen doors. So, they're $2.49 a piece. I needed two of them. Now I got enough of these for two more screen doors, and I got my problem solved. The last thing that you want to do is there's a little tiny nail in there, and what that does is that nail, even if the screws comes loose, even if the screws vibrate loose for some reason, this little tiny nail keeps it, you know, centered where you want it centered. So that's the last thing you want to go ahead and pop that sucker up in there. The only reason I'm not going to do that right now is because I'm thinking of possibly, the owner's thinking of possibly adding some weatherproofing around here, and if that's the case, this thing will have to move. So he's going to get these little pins along with the trailer, and I'm not going to put them in there now because I'm not putting that in there. I'm just not sure that that's what we want to do yet. So right now I just want to keep the cats out. That's my main goal here. So that's it. Okay, so that looks really good. It works really good. There you go. Get a little sawdust off and clean it off, get the fingerprints off. Now you got a nice closing door there. Doesn't that look nice? Now I'd also like to go ahead and thank the people that have donated to my website. You can't believe how much that's helped me. It helps a great deal. There are a lot of costs involved with going through cameras. These cheap $300 cameras, they don't last very long. This one's about ready to be replaced now again. You remember when I got this. And batteries, constantly upgrading, having to upgrade programs for editing, computers, all the time it takes. And I don't have a real job. I'm too old and too experienced for what I do for a living, so nobody wants me. So I'm limited to whatever resources I can get out there to for an income. So if you like what you see here, you think I've helped you and saved you some money, go ahead and hit that donate button on my website. And all you people that have already donated, I sure appreciate it. You just don't know how much I appreciate that. Thank you. This is Mobile Tech signing off.